pointy structures you see here are filiform papilla. What is this material here? Microbium. And then if I went up on a little bit higher magnification, we can look right in here. You can still see everything fairly well. What is this tissue here? Adipose. What tissue is here? Skeletal muscle. Okay. And again, even on the low power, you can still see and be able to tell the different tissues. So again, more detailed structures, I would try to ask on the clearest magnification, or which gave you the most of it, but with you still be able to try to determine what the thing is you're looking at to give you perspective on what the organ is, okay? What's the name of this gland?
Submandibular.
Submandibular gland, remember, there's going to be a lot of this material. What would we call this material? There's the cenine. With small clusters of? Mucus, the cenine. Okay. Then if I were to ask you what any of these structures are, that is a, again, I know the brightness isn't that great, but you can see if you were looking at the projector, computer screen or the microscope, you can see distinct nuclei lined up. Remember, any duct is going to be that uniform simple cuboidal epithelium, lined up, nice nuclei lined up right there, and there will be some type of a lumen, there will be some type of a space that's going to be found there, okay? There's that one. So since this one does follow as kind of a good comparison here, I will put up the next one. I'm trying to tell you what we're looking at here. And notice the transition here, that we have more of that other material, or say it. And so what gland am I looking at now? I'm looking at the sub-what? Sublingual. All right, so here in the sublingual gland, we look up close here. What is this material that you see that is very pale? Mucus is cenine. In a couple of places, we push out those other cells, and they kind of make these nice little caps on the end. What would we call those little caps? That's a serous demilune. So, this one I could ask on the higher power here, because you can see that there's demilunes on the high power, but one thing that you should be able to see is that there's quite a bit of mucus acini. So if you see large amounts of that mucus acini, they're taking up most of the screen, think sublingual gland. Okay, and again, you can see those little cells there, the serous demilunes. Now I can come back out here and I can ask any number of these little guys here. Two nice sized ones there. And these are going to show up probably, I think, a bit more clear. And so if we see that, who is this and who is that? Salivary. Those are salivary ducts. The salivary duct is going to look the same in the sublingual and the submandibular gland. Okay, so it will be a salivary duct. This one you can see the nice uniform cuboidal cells there. Okay? So you can see those a little bit clearly, but again, a salivary duct is a salivary duct, so there's not going to be any difference there. All right. Okay. Another comparative one. State is it in? Not the uterus.
Mammary gland.
Mammary gland. resting. All right, so these little sections that you see, what would we call this section? A lobule. What tissue makes up the lobule? Glandular alveoli. What do I call all of this loose stuff outside of the lobules? Interlobular connective tissue. What would that big guy be right there? First duct. And then remember that there is varying amounts of a bigger cluster of it. I'm seeing like couples of cells, but not much. Oh, this is good. Those loose cells that you see here, these are all going to be adipose. All right. Now again, since that is a comparative slide, we will look at the now here, notice, same magnification. I'm on that middle magnification as I was earlier. So notice that my lobules now take up almost the entire screen, correct? All right, so I won't ask lobules on a lactating one, okay? Because they take up pretty much everything. So what tissue is this, though? Glandular alveoli. The little compressed tissue that kind of makes these little pathways in between that, that's the interlobular connective tissue. I won't ask adipose on this because the adipose gets squished. So I would ask that on the resting gland as well. So the adipose, you can see some of it, but it'll... I will stick to asking for that on the resting mammary gland. And then I have here some very large, kind of amongst this tissue. These are a very large selective stuff. All right. All right, let's see. Okay, here we go. All right, what organ is this? That is the esophagus, very good. All right, so think layers and look for on the answer choices the layer and then the specific part of that layer, because remember the mucosa has three parts and remember that the muscularis has two. So on the test it might say mucosa / lamina propria, or it may just say lamina propria, okay? So keep that in mind. So what tissue is this? Stratified squamous epithelium? Non-keratinized. What would be that thin layer right there beyond it? Lamina propria. This thin band beyond it would be the muscularis mucosa. All three of those layers, remember, make up the mucosa. So this loose stuff back here behind the muscularis mucosa would be the submucosa as well. If we move to the outer edge, we now are in this layer that has two components to it. We would call this layer the muscularis. This would be the circular, this would be longitudinal, the outer layer would be the adventitia on the esophagus, serosa on everybody else.
So that first? Sorry.
Yes, go ahead.
Okay, so the stratified skin, yes, would be the...
Right here?
Okay, all of that.
Yep.
Okay.
All the way to the lumen. This is, you know, I don't know, junk.
Yeah.
But this is stratified squamous epithelium non-correct. Okay?
And then the next.
That little bit lamina propria, muscularis mucosa, submucosa, circular longitudinal beyond that. All right, since we're here.